So students and teachers and mentors, let's start with what we are actually here for, the session on learning artificial intelligence, generative AI and ChatGPT. So hope you all are all excited. Yes, so I can see the excitement in the YouTube live chat. Keep your comments coming in. So let's, what we'll be discussing today, these are the broad basic things that we'll be discussing today. First, we'll discuss about what AI is, what ChatGPT is, how to use it and where to use it. So we'll be trying to keep this session more and more interactive and more experiment based. So there will be many instances where I'll be just minimizing the screen, going on to ChatGPT window and some other tools also. So we'll be going there and we'll be having, trying to experiment, write different stuff and see how you can use it for your Tinkerpreneur journey. So as Shubham also mentioned earlier, like Tinkerpreneur is basically building digital products. So I think most of the students participating in this edition will be building their first ever digital venture. So basically, just to make it clear, a venture is anything, a kind of a small digital startup that will be trying to identify and solve some kind of a problem people are facing in the society. So just a tip before starting Tinkerpreneur, try and identify one single problem which is very unique, very novel and very innovative. Take that problem, try to find out what exactly are the areas you are going to solve, how you are going to solve it, and then what you'll have to do is that you'll just have to go ahead and implement the solution. So starting with the AI and ChatGPT session, so first let's have a look at what artificial intelligence is. So artificial intelligence is a very simple topic. It's in the trend a lot, like you hear over it many days. Like whenever I go on Twitter, there are at least 4 or 5 threads which keep on telling about how AI is cool, how you can use AI and what are different type of tools that are coming out. If you go to various websites, then you will see that there is like a lot of new tools coming over every day that uses artificial intelligence to make your life much more easy. So we'll be trying to have a look on these tools, some of these tools, and experiment with them. And so if you want to explain AI to a kid, so how you'll be explaining it? So AI is nothing but a kind of a intelligence, but that is artificial. So artificial intelligence is nothing but intelligence, which is artificial and in a machine. Okay, so we can generally just say that it is something that simulates human intelligence so that they can act like us. Now, let's try to make it a little bit more simpler. Consider this is a box. Okay, this is a simple system that has no information, just like a computer. Does your computer have any information or any intelligence? No, right? So you need to program intelligence. So by using different type of softwares, by using different type of hardwares, you are actually teaching it how to do stuff. Okay, so AI is also something similar thing. It is just used by machines to simulate human intelligence so that they can try and act like us. Okay, so they are used for variety of things, like they are used for solving problems, they're used for identifying data, making decisions. Like if you have a lot amount of data, but you want to, and it is very difficult for you to actually analyze it, so AI helps you doing it. So it can help you increase your productivity by making your life and task a little bit easier. So हम लोग एक छोटा सा समरी ले लेंगे कि AI क्या होता है और इसमें हमें क्या क्या चीजें बताया गया है. So इसमें हमें बेसिकली बस इतना ही जानना है कि AI बेसिकली एक टेक्निक है, एक टेक्नोलॉजी है जिससे हम एक मशीन को इंटेलिजेंट बनाते हमारी तरह. So हम लोग यानी ह्यूमंस, हम लोग जिस तरह से सोचते हैं, जिस तरह से बर्ताव करते हैं, वैसे मशीन बर्ताव करे, वो सिखाने का जो टेक्नोलॉजी है उसको हम लोग AI बोलते हैं. और इसको हम लोग कौन कौन से जगह पर यूज करते हैं उसे देखते हैं. सो इसको हम लोग गेमिंग में यूज करते हैं. आप सब लोग गेमिंग करते रहेंगे, राइट? सो विच आर द काइंड ऑफ गेम्स दैट यू प्ले? चेस, पबजी, माइनक्राफ्ट, पैकमैन. सो ऑल ऑफ दीज गेम्स एंड मेनी अदर गेम्स, एवरीथिंग हैज अ कंप्यूटर प्लेयर, राइट? So you play a one player game or a two player game. When you are a one player game, so the other part, the second player, is generally a computer. So how is it trained? It's an example of artificial intelligence. Similarly, in healthcare, we have seen that diagnosis and surgery is done by using AI. In entertainment mein jab aap YouTube browse karte hai, Netflix use karte hai, Instagram browse karte hai, to aapka next post kya aane wala hai? that is designed by algorithms, and these algorithms use machine learning and AI techniques to decide.
Screen unavailable आ रहा है, एक मिनट रुकते हैं.
Okay. आएगा तो बता देना, चालू होगा. Okay,
when we can start.
Yeah, we can start. Sorry students, so I think there was a minor glitch because of which the stream went unavailable, a small minor glitch on the technical side. We are live now and we are ready to resume. So we were discussing about different kind of applications of AI where AI is used. So for example, we use it in industries like gaming for games, for healthcare in the field of diagnosis and surgery. Similarly, in the field of entertainment, we use it for algorithms, like to decide what exactly comes next. Like aap jab browse karte hai YouTube ya Instagram, to next YouTube ka video kaun sa aayega. So that all is designed using a algorithm and machine learning technique. Similarly, building robots. You have seen robots like Sophia, jo recently it was like ek saal pehle it was very much popular and all over the place because it used to converse with people and it used to behave and talk to them. So similarly, there are different kind of robots used in industries and factories also. Like Amazon warehouse consists of a lot of robots that helps, you know, like take the parcel and move it and use it for dispatchment very easily. Okay, so ab in the next topic, let's have a look at what generative AI is. Okay, generative AI is a small branch of AI which helps you to generate different content. Like when you use these AI techniques to generate different type of content, such as let's say text, pictures, video, audio, anything. Let's say presentations like what we are presenting now. These all type of stuff are called as generative AI. So this is a kind of a simple artificial intelligence system jo hame help karta hai ki alag alag tarah ka content banane mein, jaise text ho gaya, video ho gaya, pictures ho gaya, audio ho gaya, etc. बहुत सारे अलग अलग तरह के जनरेटिव एआई टूल्स होते हैं, इसमें से हम कुछ यूज करेंगे आज. सो अलग अलग तरह के जो टूल्स होते हैं वो कुछ कुछ टेक्स्ट जनरेशन टूल्स होते हैं, जैसे चैट जीपीटी जो हम लोग आज डिटेल में देखेंगे. इसके अलावा वी ऑल्सो हैव मेनी ऑडियो टूल्स जो वॉइस जनरेट करता है. लाइक आप टेक्स्ट लिख कर दे दोगे और उससे वॉइस ऑटोमेटिकली जनरेट होगा. वैसे कुछ विजुअल टूल्स होता है लाइक डैली, मिड जर्नी, ऐसे जो टूल्स होते हैं, दीज आर बेसिकली इमेज जनरेटर्स. सिमिलरली कोडिंग, like people, there are many software developers who are actually interested in using like taking and generating bytes of code. So GitHub Copilot and even to in some extent ChatGPT helps you generate code a lot easily. Now coming to the next and the most important thing that we'll be focusing today with respect to our competition Tinkerpreneur, so ChatGPT. So ChatGPT in the last few months it has been used very extensively. It was considered as the fastest application to reach a million downloads, even faster than WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook ever. So ChatGPT basically it is a simple tool that we'll be using right now after this, which will be trying to create human-like conversations using chat. So consider karo ki ek machine hai, jisse aap chat kar rahe ho, और वो मशीन बहुत ज्यादा इंटेलिजेंट है, तो ये मशीन को हम लोग चैट जीपीटी बोलते हैं। ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स हैव अ लुक दैट व्हाट ऑल स्टफ वी कैन डू। वी विल बी डूइंग सम ऑफ दिस स्टफ राइट नाउ। सो इट कैन राइट कोड, इट कैन क्रिएट डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ मार्केटिंग कंटेंट, इट कैन ट्रांसलेट, इट कैन क्रिएट रेसिपीज, इट कैन क्रिएट समरी ऑफ वेबसाइट्स, इट कैन एक्चुअली इवन पुट ऑन सम क्रिएट अ स्टोरी अराउंड इट। लेट्स से यू सेट सम कॉन्टेक्स्ट एंड यू टेल इट दैट प्रिपेयर अ स्टोरी अराउंड दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट, इट विल बी एबल टू क्रिएट इट। इट विल बी ऑल्सो एबल टू जनरेट स्क्रिप्ट फॉर मूवीज। सो ऑल ऑफ दीज विल बी ट्राइंग आउट राइट नाउ। सो द मेन important, the most important thing that you are waiting for, let's go and implement ChatGPT and try out with different things. Okay, so basically to use ChatGPT, I'll just first just Google what ChatGPT is. Okay, so and I'll just type ChatGPT on Google. Okay, so the first result that appears over here, let's click on it. So now first we'll see that how do we use ChatGPT and how to get started. So over here you get try ChatGPT. Okay, so there are two models of ChatGPT. One is ChatGPT 3 and one is ChatGPT 4. The version of ChatGPT 3 is free to use for everyone, so we'll be using that for now. ChatGPT 4 is a bit advanced version which is able to browse the internet, and there are many more extra features, but it comes with a per month cost. So for our purpose and whatever we need to do, we'll be using ChatGPT, and that is sufficient to do everything. Okay, so abhi iska use kaise karna hai, so start karte hain. Sabse pehle main yahan par try ChatGPT pe click karunga. Okay, so I've already used ChatGPT a lot, as you can see. So for using different type of content, so I've been using ChatGPT over the last 3 months. So to do anything, there are a few examples that ChatGPT has given, like what all things you can type over here. So I'll try to click on one of these and see what happens. So the first prompt that I give, the prompt is nothing but jo main yahan par type karta hu, isi ko hum log prompt bolenge. So got any creative ideas for a 10-year-old birthday? Let's try, let's send it. And let's see what ChatGPT gives us. As you can see, a new chat is created over here, and it is generated, auto generating all the content. What all things we can do for a 10-year-old birthday? So let's say here are some examples that it has suggested. You can let me know in the chat whether these are useful or not. So first, it's an outdoor adventure. So we can organize a nature theme park. Nice idea. The other examples it has given is that you can do a science party. Okay, there is another cool theme that it has given. It is a superhero training camp where we can actually transform the party venue into a superhero training camp. Wow, that is very nice. Ek aur example jo diya gaya hai wo hai ki outdoor movie night. Ek movie night organize karo birthday party ke din. Another is given like a sports extravaganza. So ek sports ka ek competition. A sports theme party. Wow, nice idea. So basically, मैंने क्या किया, मैंने यहाँ पर कुछ भी type किया और उसके basis पे मुझे यहाँ बहुत सारे inputs और outputs मिले. So how does it generate these kind of inputs and outputs? So these outputs are generating based on the training it is provided. कोई भी AI model को अगर हमें use करना है, कोई भी AI model को बनाना है, तो हमें उसको train करना होगा. Consider करो एक computer है जिसपे कुछ knowledge नहीं है. तो आप पहले उसको train करोगे कि birthday क्या होता है. फिर उसको हम ट्रेन करेंगे कि 10 साल का बच्चा कैसा होता है और कैसा क्या क्या चीज. आफ्टर दैट वी विल बी सीइंग कि एक्चुअली में उसको क्या क्या चीजें होता है अभी के ट्रेंड के हिसाब से. ऐसा ना हो कि 1960s का थीम आइडियाज हो दे, विच इज नॉट रेलेवेंट राइट नाउ. सो सिमिलरली इट इज ट्रेंड ऑन लेट्स से मिलियंस ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ कंटेंट दैट इज ऑलरेडी अवेलेबल, एंड बेस्ड ऑन दैट इट इज प्रोवाइडिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन और इंटेलिजेंस. ओके, सो टुडे व्हाट वी विल बी डूइंग इज दैट वी विल बी trying out different type of tasks. Okay, so the first task is that we'll be trying to see how it can solve math ka problems. Okay, so what kind of math problems can it solve? Let's see. Let's take a very simple example to start with.
chatbot is 24 multiplied by 576.
Okay, so let's take this example. What is 24 multiplied by 576? Okay, it gives me an answer that the 24 multiplied by 576 is equal to 13,824. So this is an example of a very simple problem. Let's say I want to learn about, tell me the mathematical importance of pi, that is 3.14, and where it is used. Okay, so now it is telling me that how pi is used, what kind of a ratio is it, where, which all fields it is used in. Okay, let's have a look at what it has generated. So some key aspects it has stated that it's used in geometry, trigonometry, calculus, probability and statistics, number theory, cryptography, chaos theory. Wow, very interesting, right? So similarly, what everything that comes over here is important on the question. So if I were to just ask pi kya hota, what is pi, a simple question, so it would have just told ki pi is 3.14 and it is an irrational number which has the ratio of a circumference of a circle, that is to the diameter. So that is a simple thing it would. But now I told where it is used, so it has told me which all aspects where pi can actually be used. Okay, so time to move to the next task. Write a book summary. Okay, so any book summary, any book, what is your favorite book that you have used? Shubham, would you like to share any, what is your favorite book? Let's try.
The Sapiens.
Which one? Sorry?
The Sapiens. S-A-P-I-E-N.
You all know her,
are
you?
Yeah.
Sure. Let's. So I'll just write a prompt stating that write a book summary for the book The Sapiens by Yuval Noah Harari. Okay, let's have a look what it says. Okay, so first it has given me a 4-paragraph summary, and then it has also summarized it into a 3-line thing, like what is Sapiens actually about. So Shubham, what do you think? Like, is this correct based on your experience reading the book?
Yeah, definitely. It's very nicely summarized.
Okay, so this is what ChatGPT can be used for. It can be used for different type of tools like book summary. You can even write a movie summary based on it, and you can actually use it for different type of content. So how does it actually get, how these all these stuff get powered, is that like there are a lot of supercomputers, there are a lot of servers at the back end of OpenAI office, which has, whenever you type this prompt, that is write a book summary for the book The Sapiens, it goes into the server. So in the server there is a lot of processing done. What is this book about, what the different type of authors have told, is there any mention about a summary that on the internet that is already available, it might pick some part about it, then it would apply its own theory similar to how we go about it, and it would create the summary. Okay, similarly there are a lot of new stuff that you can do. So one thing that we find very useful is that write a translation. So it has created a summary in English, but let's say I don't know what French is, but let's say I have a friend by the name Killian, so who is French, who does not understand English. So I just ask ChatGPT to translate this book summary into French language. Okay, this I'm doing one of my good friends Killian, who doesn't understand English. Let's see. So this is another application that you can use ChatGPT for. So let's say you are building an app, but you want to have different type of translations for your app. So you can actually use these kind of ChatGPT to develop translations. There are a set of languages which ChatGPT-3 uses. So based on that, you'll be able to translate it into whatever language you wish to. Okay. So another thing is that you can actually write a poetry. So ChatGPT can also be used to create different type of poetry. Let's say we have Atal Tinkering Labs, right? So let's try to create a small poetry for Atal Tinkering Labs. So it can even create some kind of verses. So here are some verses that it suggests. You can have a look and let me know that whether these are useful or not. So these are some of the gimmicky kind of a stuff we can do. It can even help you write code. So if I ask it to write a Python program to create a dictionary for Indian cricket team players. Let's see what it does. So here is an example of the Python program, a kind of a dictionary-based Python program it has created. So it has given the different keys are the name and the jersey number. Like Virat Kohli has 18 as his jersey number, Rohit Sharma has it for 45, Jasprit Bumrah 33, Ravindra Jadeja 8. Okay, so these are the jersey numbers that it has assigned, and these are different names that it has. So similarly, if I would have told that I want whether he's a batsman, bowler, or an all-rounder, it would have done that also. So everything depends on what kind of a prompt. So the detailing that you give over here, if I write a one paragraph, a five-line prompt, so it will give me much more accurate results. So because it's a machine, right? उसको पता नहीं है कि उसको exactly क्या करना है. तो आपको exactly उसको समझाना पड़ेगा. कितने ज़्यादा descriptive और जितना ज़्यादा information आप उसको prompt में दे सको, तो यहाँ पर आपको देना होगा और उस basis पे वो आपको करके देगा. ओके, सो क्या आपने एक और चीज ऑब्जर्व किया कि यहाँ पर अभी उन्होंने क्रिकेट टीम के बारे में बताया, बट इसमें अभी भी कुछ प्लेयर्स है जो अभी खेल नहीं रहे इंडियन टीम में. लाइक शिखर धवन, ही हैज नॉट प्लेड फॉर इंडियन टीम सिंस अ फ्यू मंथ्स, राइट? सो दिस इज बिकॉज इट इज यूजिंग डेटा टिल द एंड ऑफ 2021. सो फ्रॉम 2022 इट इज नॉट यूजिंग डेटा. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द ड्रॉबैक्स ऑफ चैट GPT-3. सो यू विल नॉट गेट the availability of recently available data. So it is being trained on data before 2022. So if you want to use the recent data, or you want to use try and scrape the wave, try in finding or find out different information on the internet, so you'll have to use ChatGPT-4. Okay, so now coming about to Tinkerpreneur. Okay, so in Tinkerpreneur you need to create digital ventures, right? So here are some exercises that we'll be trying to do right now, based on which I hope that these will be useful for you in your Tinkerpreneur competition also, right? So let's say so now we'll be writing different type of prompts to, let's say, get some business ideas. Okay, so let's write a prompt together. So first, for creating a business idea, the prompt can be something like, I want to create a digital business, okay, which is using machine learning and AI. Or let's take a different technology, for example. I want to create a simple digital business using, blockchain. So I can write the exact words and what it has to do, okay? Let's take a more simpler example for now. Let's try to develop an e-commerce business and what kind of business ideas it can give. Write some examples of very
innovative and new business ideas in the field of e-commerce. Okay, so this is the, it should be something very novel, and let's say technologically advanced. I'm just writing anything that comes to my mind right now. Okay, let's see what kind of business ideas it gives. Okay, so it has generated the content. So let's see what the response is about. So the first idea that it gives is that there are some virtual try-on for clothing or accessories. So basically using AR to allow customers to try on clothing before they purchase it. Very innovative. Another is that AI powers personalized shopping assistant. Okay, that looks good. Another is drone delivery service. One is 3D printing customizable products. Okay. And another is that a subscription box service with AI curation. So let's, for our further examples, let's take one of these examples. Like I'll take AI powered shopping assistant. Okay. So this will be our major thrust on from now. Let's see the next task. Let's create some blog articles. Okay. First, let's create some taglines. Write some taglines or slogans. So taglines basically बहुत simple चीज होता है, like Nike का आपने देखा होगा कि just do it, Adidas का आपने देखा होगा impossible is nothing. So these are some taglines or slogans that the companies use. Some taglines for my new company. Let's ask it to give some names also of the company. Based on So I'll just copy it from here. So it's AI powered shopping assistant. Let's see what kind of names this ChatGPT give our company. Okay, so first is that AIVO, that is Artificial Intelligence Virtual Operator, and the slogan or tagline it has given is that your personalized shopping companion in the digital age. Okay, another is Shop Smart AI, shopping made smarter with AI powered assistance. Then there is Persona AI, Personal AI Shopper. These are some of the names that it has given. If you don't like it, you can ask it to give some more names also. So, because it's a computer engine, right? So you can, it's not like a normal person will be a bit angry or frustrated when you ask them something. So it is an AI engine. So you can ask whatever you want. Let's say, suggest some more. I did not like it, something like that. So something different. Okay. So here are some different names and taglines it has suggested. Okay. So let's take this one, Smart Shop AI. Okay. And we'll use this Smart Shop AI for our further. Okay. Next, we'll try to ask it to create a article that will go on the blog. So write an article of OK. Okay, I'll just copy it from here. So here are the company name and tagline I need. So ChatGPT can also be used to write some kind of a blog article. So let's say what kind of a blog article it generates. So you can directly copy it and you can paste it on your thing. But the thing is that it is very important. Whenever you use any kind of AI-generated content, it is very important to verify it for fact-checking, for different type of purposes, because AI is an engine, right? An engine, though it tries to be perfect, but it is never perfect. So every time you need to apply your own brain over and above this so that you get the exact things. So here is the title it has suggested and here is this blog article. We can directly copy-paste it and create your own blog. Okay, so next thing is that suggest some, let's take, because marketing and brand building is another very important session that we'll be doing in Tinkerpreneur. So let's ask it to create some marketing plan. For the company, let's see, okay. So a marketing plan basically is an outline of all the activities that you'll be doing to make your company successful. So after you build the product, the next thing is that you'll be selling it, your product, to the different people, right? So marketing is basically जिस तरह से आप अपने product को अलग अलग लोगों तक पहुंचाते हो और उनको जानकारी देते हो कि मेरे product में ये है. लेट से हमारा जो AI का जो अभी प्रोडक्ट बना है तो उसके लिए हम लोग क्या क्या तरह के मार्केटिंग टेक्निक्स यूज करते हैं. ओके, सो हियर आर द डिफरेंट स्टेप्स इट इज सजेस्टिंग. फर्स्ट इट इज आस्किंग मी टू डिफाइन हु माय ऑडियंस इज, देन आइडेंटिफाई द यूएसपी फॉर इट, व्हाट विल बी द मैसेजिंग दैट विल बी गोइंग, व्हाट विल बी द influencer marketing aspects that we will have to do, what kind of partnerships we'll have to do. Okay, so similarly another thing is that now if our marketing is ready, we want to publish some social media posts. Okay, right, let's ask it to write some social media post captions. Let's see what kind of social media post captions need. So if I specify that I want something for LinkedIn, it will curate it according to LinkedIn. If I ask it to specify something for Instagram, it will be creating something for Instagram with the kind of hashtags that is relevant for that. If I want it for something for Twitter, it will create something in less than 160 characters. So similarly, it has, here are some kind of content that it has suggested. Okay, so these are the different type of tools that you can do. Apart from this, what all things you can do is that you can add, like, let's say you want to create a video. So you can ask ChatGPT to actually create a video script. So what you will do is that you will enter a prompt, write a video script for my video, kind of a launch video for this product. And then it will be, and give some description about the product. And based on that, it will be able to create your own script. Okay. And then launch plan, then there can be some kind of elevator pitches and all. These all things can also be mentioned. So these kind of exercises, the list of exercises also, I asked ChatGPT yesterday, what all kind of exercises that you can do for a competition like Tinkerpreneur. So these are some of the exercises that it has actually suggested. So ye sab cheeze wahan se aa rahi hai. Kya kya cheeze ChatGPT nahi kar sakte? Okay, so ChatGPT kuch cheeze nahi, it's very difficult for ChatGPT. First, the first and foremost thing is that ChatGPT-3 is using content from like I think it's still end of December 2021. So from Jan 2022, it is not using the content, the online content. So that's why there can be some factual errors. There can be some errors in the content and code because it's an engine and it depends how well it is trained. So there can be some kind of errors in the content and the code, the computer programming code that it is developing. There can be some legal and ethical issues. So I'll just share something that I saw in the newspaper today itself. So today's Times of India newspaper, on the front page, it has a headline that a lawyer from New York, he was actually using ChatGPT for his case. But he actually asked all the details, what kind of previous cases are there, but it actually turned out factually incorrect. So he was actually summoned, there were some sanctions imposed on him. So these kind of tools, these kind of errors can happen. So whenever you use any kind of generative AI tool, so you can actually, you need to factually verify it from the internet, apply your own brain. It's a machine, right? So you need to apply your own brain and your critical thinking ability to make it very, very useful. Next thing is that personalized advice. So you can, like, there are people who have seen that they go to ChatGPT and they say that I'm having cough, can you recommend some medicines? So these kind of stuff you need to go to the doctor and you need to ask, right? Because ChatGPT won't be able to give you anything personalized, because they don't know who Suman is or Shubham is or Rahul is or Dhruv is. So he or she, like, the machine won't be able to know your medical history or anything, right? So based on that, so kind of personal advice, like, you need to try and avoid asking it for personalized advice. Some kind of limitations. It is, like we already mentioned, like, it's not fact checked, it has no common sense and any creativity. So based on the common sense, the data or common sense it has been fed on, so based on that it acts. And there is also very important kind of problem that we have seen, is that the potential bias. There is a bias that the ChatGPT creates based on the data it is trained. Recently there were some political issues in the US, and it was giving a right wing view or a left wing view for any topic. So you need to be very, very careful, because it has some kind of bias, though they are trying to create it as neutral as possible, but it has some kind of bias, so you need to verify it. Okay, so we are proceeding towards the end of the session. So these are some three tools that are very, very interesting that I would actually ask you all to try out after this session. Okay, so these are some tools other than ChatGPT. So ChatGPT is not the only generative AI tool. You can also use Google Bard, which is also very easy. Okay, and it is also completely free. So you can also try out Google Bard for your uses or for help, like creating different type of content for Tinkerpreneur. So these are three kind of special tools that we have seen. One is Beethoven AI. So this tool is very interesting. So you can just type this on Google and you can go to the site, and it is basically helping you create your own music. Like, you're creating different type of videos, right? For ATL marathon also you created your own video, but for that you need to have your own music. You can't use any song from any Bollywood music in your video, right? There will be a copyright strike. So this Beethoven AI helps you create your own music, completely original, based on the prompts that you give. Tome is an example of a very interesting tool which helps you create PowerPoint presentations. Okay, you give some kind of input, it will create a kind of a 8 slide or 10 slide presentation based on it. Then there are tools like DALL-E and Midjourney, wherein you give prompts like these. Like, let's say I want to create a prompt, I give a prompt like, design an image of an Indian kid studying computer science in his classroom. So it will be creating an own AI art based on that. Okay, another one is, this one is 11 Labs. 11 Labs is very, very interesting. So we have recently launched a podcast series of Tinkerpreneur, right? So 11 Labs is something, a kind of AI text to speech synthesizing AI. Like, agar aapko samjho ki agar aapko text dalna hai aur usse aapko baat karwana hai, like ek computer machine se narrate karana hai. लेट से आपने एक वीडियो बनाना है, उसके आपने म्यूजिक के अलावा आपको नरेशन भी देना, तो आप वो टेक्स्ट को पूरा का पूरा टाइप कर दोगे, एग्जैक्टली वही चीज को यूज करके एआई अपने हिसाब से नरेट करेगा. सो दीज आर सम सिंपल सिंपल टूल्स दैट आई वुड सजेस्ट यू ऑल टू ट्राई आउट आफ्टर द सेशन एंड्स. यू हैव अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम, ऑल ऑफ दीज टूल्स हैव अ फ्री वर्जन, सो यू कैन गो ओवर, देयर आर नो पेमेंट अलोंग एनीथिंग रिक्वायर्ड, यू कैन जस्ट गो ऑन द साइट, जस्ट एक्सपेरिमेंट यूजिंग इट एंड ट्राई टू जनरेट डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ कंटेंट. Okay, so this brings out to the end of the session. Hope you all have learned a lot about artificial intelligence and how you can use ChatGPT, generative AI, and how we'll be using it in your Tinkerpreneur. Okay, so next, what's next? Okay, so you have learned about ChatGPT in your first session. This is your first session, but there are many more weeks to come in the Tinkerpreneur journey, right? Now, let's have a look at what Tinkerpreneur is and the different type of things that you'll be doing on these weeks. Okay. Okay, Shubham, so can you explain? I'll try to load the calendar till then, if you can explain.
Yeah, sure. So, students, you have learned the very first skill, ChatGPT. It has been included for this year, Tinkerpreneur, at the very first time. Okay, all the other 17 skills you are watching on the content on KidX portal has already been available for the last 2 years as well. Okay, so please make sure that you start attempting and reading the content of all these 17-18 digital skills. Okay, and there is a quiz attached to each of these digital skills. Each quiz is live. Okay, and here is the calendar for all of the sessions which we would be holding for you. Okay, so we are sitting on June 10th. Learn GPT. We have today have learned about ChatGPT. Okay, and then June 13th is our second session where we would be learning the cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is not the skill which is present on the content part, but we have tried to make it as a learning skill for you as an additional skill, which is very important in this early age as well. Okay, then we would be starting with our week, where June 16, we would be coming up with our expert session on how to build and refine your digital products. Okay, coming down, Suman. Yeah, so then each week, starting from week 2, we would be also having handhold me session by the students. So these sessions would be taking up by the students and for the students. Okay, so you would be learning it more, ki how they have developed their product in the previous two seasons. Then coming on to week 3, we would be learning about the business models, how to create and develop them. Okay, there would be expert session and handholding session for each week. Then week 4, we would be learning about digital marketing and digital branding. Okay, and then coming on to the week 5, we have business finance, very nicely curated expert session. July 6th and July 9th is the handhold me session. Then we would be learning about how to build up your online store on July 13 and July 16. Then comes to the last week, week 7, which is the final sales and investor pitch, is July 20, and July 23 is the handhold me session. So July 24, we would be ending the bootcamp with a very special session. It's in store for you. And August 6 is the final submission of the pitch deck. Okay. Each of the content for every week has 4 major things. I am repeating, and listen to me very carefully. 4 major things. Okay. And over the email, we have also sent the manual for you on how you can operate the KidX portal. Okay, so first thing first, on each of the content, on the second bullet, you would be finding out a PDF version on everything. Okay, and then there would be the fifth or the last bullet, which would be the assignment submission. The template of the assignment submission is given there. Then the second tab of your content would be the quiz section, okay, where you can attempt the quiz. It's a very simple a quiz for 5 to 6 questions where you can just test your knowledge. Okay, then third tab is the my videos section, where you can just see the videos. We have uploaded all the videos of all the content. Okay, and then at the last, you would be having the submissions tab, where you would be submitting your assignments. Assignments can be submitted only in 3 forms: PDF, video, or image form. And we have explicitly written on each of the content on how you can submit those assignments. Okay, so you are now sitting on week 1. Calm yourself down and just learn on those digital skills for week 1. Keep your week 1 parked for only digital skills. Because if you rush, then you won't be getting the proper mentoring support on how to build that product more effectively. Okay. Now, at the very last of it, a special announcement, or you can say a special screen share by Suman. So this is our channel on Spotify, ATL Tinkerpreneur 2023. Okay, on Spotify, you can just type ATL Tinkerpreneur 2023 and you would be getting the Telugu, Tamil, Punjabi and other regional languages podcast. Okay, but these podcasts would be starting from week 2. Okay, so we would be uploading more and more languages here. So right now you have Punjabi, Kannada, Gujarati, Hindi, Bengali, Telugu, all of them. For
yeah, I think
2.
Some more are coming, right?
We would be adding 4 and 5 more, so total 12 regional languages for each week, and this podcast would be updated as we go along for each of the week. Okay, so as soon as we would be starting on week 3, all the week 3 regional languages podcast would be uploaded. And for this, I would like to thank all the mentors who have volunteered for recording their podcast and giving us the best of the content we can have. It is the 15-20 minute short podcast where you just can listen and just learn those skills, polish your skills even further. Yeah, and thank you so much, Suman, for joining us and giving that overview of how ChatGPT can be used in a more effective way, both in their own personal lives as well as in the Tinkerpreneur journey. And I just hope that all these students would be using this ChatGPT in a more effective and ethical manner. Okay, and just try to use it for a more purposeful sense. Okay, and yes, it is a very powerful tool and trending tool as well. Okay, we would be also scheduling some of the orientation sessions for mentors as well as students in the upcoming week. So stay tuned with AIM, and I hope that all of you have joined the Telegram channel of ATL Tinkerpreneur 2023. If not, please look out for your emails, and the very first link is for the Telegram link which you can join to get the all updates of Tinkerpreneur. Okay, so for the expert session, this is it, and on June 13th, we would be joining you to learn cybersecurity. Okay, and there are some tremendous speakers we have onboarded this time for Tinkerpreneur. Thank you all educators, teachers, students, mentors for joining. Suman, any last words from you?
Yeah, thank you everyone for joining. Hope you all enjoyed it. So just before going out, do subscribe to our channel and like this video and share it with your friends also so that they learn. Do try to attend as many sessions as much as possible so that your digital product is the most innovative and the best one. So all the best.
Thank you, everyone.